now and forevermore. Amen. Holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Salvation on this day has come unto all the world. Let us sing and praise Him who rose from the tomb, and who is also the author of life, having vanquished death by death, by His own death. This victory He bestowed on us, and His boundless mercy.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and unto the end of the ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
For the whole world, for the stability of God's holy churches, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the whole church, and for those who have entered with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever-growing Mary of the thanks to the Lord for his miracles, mercies, and wonders to the sons of men. Let them exalt him in the assembly of the people and praise him in the seat of the elders.
Save us, O Son of God, who are risen from the dead. We sing to you, Alleluia.
The eyes of the Lord are on those who hope in his mercy.
Save us, O Son of God, who are risen from the dead. We sing to you, Alleluia.
To hear the groaning of those bound, to set free the sons of the slain.
Save us, O Son of God, who are risen from the dead. We sing to you, Alleluia. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Only begotten Son and Word, immortal One, who for our salvation did so humble yourself by taking on flesh, from the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, without shame did you become man. You were crucified, Christ our God, trampling down death by your death. As one of the Holy Trinity, and being glorified together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, say,
worship and bow down before Christ.
Save us, O Son of God, who are risen from the dead. We sing to you, Alleluia.
Let us worship the Word who is unoriginate, with the Father and the Spirit, and from a virgin was born. For our salvation, O believers, and let us sing his praise. For in his goodness he was pleased to ascend
Spirit,
now and
ever unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Share ill treatment with the people of God than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. And what more shall I say? For time would fail me to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel and the prophets, who through faith conquered kingdoms, enforced justice, received promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched raging fire, escaped the edge of the sword, won strength out of weakness, became mighty in war, put enemies to flight. Women received their dead by resurrection. Some were tortured, refusing to accept release, that they might rise again to a better life. Others suffered mocking and scourging, and even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned. They were sawn in two. They were killed with the sword. They went about in skins of sheep and goats, destitute, afflicted, ill-treated, of whom the world was not worthy, wandering over deserts and mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. And in all these, though well attested by their faith, did not receive what was promised, since God had foreseen something better for us, that apart from us they should not be made perfect.
Peace be with you, the reader. Come see. Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him And he said of him, Behold, an Israelite indeed in whom there is no guile. Nathanael said to him, How do you know me? And Jesus answered him, Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you. Nathanael answered him, Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. And Jesus answered him, Because I saw, said to you, I saw you under a fig tree, do you believe? You shall see greater things than these. And he said to him, Truly, truly, I say to you, you will see the gates of heaven open. And the angels of God, ascending and descending upon the Son of Man.
Glory to you.
Sunday of Orthodoxy. Today is the day that we commemorate the Empress Theodora, who, after a few hundred years, finally reinstated the holy use of icons. For after the sixth ecumenical council and before the seventh, there was a time called iconoclasm. Iconoclasm, simply put, means basically a hatred of icons. So the churches in Constantinople and the Eastern Roman Empire, the Byzantine Empire at the time, had all of their icons removed. And there were simple crosses put on the walls, and that is about all you would have found at that time. There were many saints who spoke against it, but it was the way the land for a long time. And the use of icons was the way that the church finally came to grips with the first six councils of the church and how we as Orthodox Christians understand the God-man. All of the councils, every single one of the ecumenical councils, had to do with how we understand Jesus Christ and the Holy Trinity. Primarily Jesus Christ. How can God be man? How can the eternal, how can that which is beyond comprehension? We say it in the liturgy, hear it every Sunday. That which he is who is beyond comprehension, beyond knowing. It, you know, all of these big words that remove us from knowing him. How can this God be one of us? How can this be? And many heresies were created trying to explain it. But at the end of the day, you all need to know one thing. Jesus Christ was physically a human being just like you. If you believe otherwise, it's wrong. It's not an orthodox thought that you have in your mind. We fought for 750, almost 780 years trying to understand the humanity of Jesus Christ. So to have a thought that is contrary to that is not orthodox. To be orthodox is to believe that Jesus Christ is both fully God and fully man. Because if he's not, you are not saved. Period, full stop, end of story. If he is not fully God and fully man, you have no hope. Because only God can save you, and only by him sharing in our likeness did he redeem the fallen nature of Adam. Only by taking on humanity and suffering death like we suffer death, where are we able to live in a resurrected body like he has a resurrected body? This is our hope. Our hope is that one day we will be just like him by grace, right? Isn't that what St. Athanasius said? We become by grace what he is by nature, because he became what we are, except without sin. This is the mystery of Orthodoxy. This is the mystery of Christianity. This is the glory of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that he, throughout time, has had icons that point the way to him. We have the gospel as an icon. It's an image of his truth. It contains a perfect and beautiful account of his glory and his saving grace. David read this morning the epistle from Hebrews, where Paul enumerates all of these icons from the Old Testament, Moses and Abraham, the prophets. And all through time, these people who were killed and scourged and sawn in half, of whom we are not worthy. These are all icons of the mercy of God. Just like the icons on the wall are all particular images of the grace of Jesus Christ in Orthodoxy, that he saved each and every one of them in their bodies. That by his grace, by his resurrection, we can now participate in him. And we, in the rest of the body, we are participating in a cosmic reality, which is Jesus Christ, our resurrected Lord. May he be glorified in his saints. May he be triumphant in eternity and in our souls as we more and more, by the grace of the Holy Spirit, come to understand the resurrection. We come to understand his love. We come to understand our place in him as our head, our God, and our King. Amen.
All right.
And ever guarded by your might, may us cry glory to you, the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us through his
Trinity, the love. Oh, Lord.
Christian
Consider our sacrifice and accept it as you accepted the gifts of Abel, the offerings of Noah, Abraham's whole burnt offerings, the priests and ministries of Moses and Aaron, the peace offerings of Samuel. And as you accepted this true worship from your holy apostles, likewise, with your goodness and love, Lord, accept these gifts from our simple hands, so that having been judged worthy to offer with you a blameless sacrifice at this holy altar, we may attain the reward of the faithful and prudent stewards upon the fearful day of your just and impending judgment. So, we're doing the liturgy of St. Basil the Great today, if you didn't know, and there's longer prayers and different prayers. So I'm going to take the time to read them so you can hear them, because they are not in that particular book that you're using, and that's why I'm doing what I'm doing, in case you're curious, okay? And we do this liturgy each of the four Sundays of Lent leading up to Holy Week, and then we do it a couple of times during Holy Week as well.
Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and mighty, reigning Spirit, both now and forever, and in the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your Spirit.
Christ is in the unis, and never shall be. Catholic and Apostolic Church. I am all as one baptism for the remission of sins, the one resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world which to come. Amen.
Let us stand well, let us stand in fearless, take care to our the holy oblation in peace.
Merciful peace, a sacrifice of
and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit.
right, just, and befitting the greatness of your holiness, that we praise you, sing to you, bless you, adore you, give thanks to you, glorify you as the only true God, that with repentant hearts and in a spirit of humility we may offer you this, our spiritual worship. For you have given us grace to know your truth. Who could so much as speak of your lordship or sing you do praises or recount your countless wonders throughout the ages? Master of all, Lord of heaven and earth and of all creation, seen and unseen, you are he who is enthroned upon the seat of glory, able to plumb the depths of eternal, invisible, and beyond comprehending or describing, unchanging, as the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the great God and Savior, the object of our hope. For he is the image of your goodness, the seal bearing your perfect likeness, revealing you, his Father, through himself. He is the living Word, true God, wisdom beyond the ages, light, sanctification, power, and the true life. Through him, the Holy Spirit was made manifest, the Spirit of truth, the gift of adoption, the foretaste of the future inheritance, the first fruits of eternal blessings, the life-giving power and fountainhead of our holiness. Empowered by him, every rational and intelligent being sings ceaselessly of your glory, for all serve you. It is you that the angels and the archangels adore, the thrones and the dominions, the principalities, the virtues, the powers and the cherubim with many eyes. It is you, the seraphim encircle, each with their six wings. With two they cover their face, with two their feet, and the others they fly. They cry out one to another with ceaseless voice in perpetual praise and saying, and singing, and proclaiming and shouting the victory hymn and saying,
promising him immortality and the enjoyment of everlasting blessings and the keeping of your commandments. But once he disobeyed you, the true God who created him, and he fell under the serpent's guile and became subject to death by his own transgression. In your just judgment, O God, you exiled him from paradise into this world, returning him to the earth from which he was first taken, yet you planned for him salvation through the rebirth in your Christ. For you did not turn away altogether from what you had made, gracious Lord, nor did you forget the work of your hands. But in the depth of your love, you watched over him in your many ways. You sent forth prophets, you worked mighty signs through your saints, who in each generation were pleasing to you. You spoke to us through the mouths of your servants, the prophets, announcing to us beforehand the salvation that was to come. You gave the law as a guide, you sent angels as guardians. And when the fullness of time came, you spoke to us through your very Son, through whom you created the ages. For though he is the reflection of your glory and the very likeness of your person, sustaining all things by the power of his word, he did not account equality with you, our God and Father, a thing to be grasped. But though he was God before all time, he was seen on earth and he lived among men. And taking flesh from the Holy Virgin, he emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of our lowly body, so that he might change us to be like his glorious body. For since it was by man that sin entered the world, and death through sin, your only begotten Son, he who was in the bosom of God the Father, condescended to be born of a woman, the Holy Theotokos, the ever-Virgin One. reborn under the law, so as to condemn sin in his flesh, so that those who die in Adam may be brought to life in him, your Christ. And having lived in this world, and having given precepts for salvation, turning us away from the delusion of idolatry, he brought us to the knowledge of you, the true God and Father, redeeming us to himself as a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. And when he had cleansed us in water and sanctified us with the Holy Spirit, he gave himself up as a ransom to death, to which we were in bondage, sold under sin. He descended into Hades by way of the cross, that he might fill all things in himself and lose the pains of death. Rising on the third day, he prepared the way for the resurrection of all from the dead, and because it was not possible for him, the author of life, to be held by death, he thus became the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything he might be preeminent. Ascending into heaven, he was enthroned at the right hand of you and your majesty on high, and when he shall come to render to each of us according to his deeds. But he left us remembrances of his saving passion, these which we have set forth as he commanded. For he was about to go forth to his voluntary and eternally memorable and life-giving death. On the night when he had given himself up for the life of the world, taking bread in his holy, spotless hands, and presenting it to you, our God and Father, he gave thanks and he blessed it and he sanctified it and he broke it. And he said, he gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, take, eat, this is my body which has been broken for you for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Likewise, taking the cup of the fruit of the vine, mixing it and giving thanks, and blessing and sanctifying it, he said, and gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which has been shed for you and for many for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Let this be remembered to me, for whenever you eat of this bread or drink of this cup, you proclaim my death and confess my resurrection. Therefore, Master, as we too remember his saving sufferings, the life-giving cross, the third day, 3 days in the tomb, the resurrection from the dead, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement at your right hand, O God, our Father, and his good and glorious and awesome second return. And offering you these gifts from your own, in all and for all.
Temple and rush.
back those who have strayed, uniting them with your holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Liberate those who are troubled by unclean spirits, sail with those who sail, accompany those who travel. Plead for the widow, shield the orphan, free the captive, heal the afflicted. Will God look after those who are on trial or condemned to the mines or exiled in bitter slavery, or in any way hard-pressed in want or extremity, and all who stand in need of your boundless compassion. Those who love us as well as those who hate us, as those who have empowered us, unworthy though we are, to pray on their behalf. Be mindful, Lord, of our God, of all your people. Lavish upon us all your rich mercy, granting to us all that leads to salvation. And if we have failed to commemorate anyone, without out of ignorance or forgetfulness, or because of the great multitude of names, you, O God, remember, for you know each one's age and name, since you have known each of us from our mother's womb. For you, O Lord, are the help of the helpless, the hope of the hopeless, the rescuer of the tempest-tossed, safe haven for sailors, healer of the sick. You know all things to all people, for you know each of us and what we have asked for our homes and for our needs. Defend this city, O Lord, this community and every city and land, against famine and pestilence, earthquake and flood, against fire and the sword, against alien attack and for civil strife. And, Lord, remember among the first our Archbishop Isaiah. Grant that he may serve your holy churches in peace. Keep him safe, honorable, and healthy for a length of years, rightly teaching the word of your truth. And remember all those whom each of us have called to mind, and all people everywhere.
And all people everywhere.
Also, the fullness of your mercy, remember my unworthy person. Forgive me of my many transgressions, voluntary and involuntary. Do not allow me to sin, nor may my sins block the grace of your Holy Spirit from the gifts here set forth. Remember, Lord, all priests and deacons in Christ and every priestly and monastic order. May none of us who surround your sacred altar be put to shame. Watch over us in your goodness, Lord. Manifest yourself to us in your abundant mercy. Grant us temperate and healthful season and gentle rains, that the earth may yield its fruit. Bless the cycle of the year by your grace. Bring an end to the divisions of the churches. Quiet the arrogance of the nations by the mighty Holy Spirit speedily put down the revolts of heresies. Receive us all in your kingdom, declaring us children of light, children of the day. Lord our God, give us your peace by your love. And grant that with one voice and heart we may glorify and praise your most excellent and majestic name. Of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And so become the temple of your holiness. Glorify none of us guilty of profaning these lost and heavenly mysteries, but let us be enfeebled in soul or body by receiving them unworthily. Grant that to our very last breath we may receive the portion of your sacred gifts as the way to eternal life or an acceptable defense at the dread judgment seat of your Christ. That we too, with the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may share in your eternal blessings, be shared to those who love you, Lord our God. For yours is the kingdom, power, and glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
To you.
Sinners, of whom I am first.
I also believe that it is truly your pure body, and that this is truly your precious blood. Therefore, I pray to you, have mercy on me, and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and in deed, known and unknown, and make me worthy of the life of creation, to participate in your mysteries, for the forgiveness of sins, and for life eternal. Amen.
How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of your saints? If I dare to enter into the bridal chamber, my clothing will accuse me, since it is not a wedding garment, and being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Loving Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my condemnation, because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of soul and body, and for the pledge of future life and kingdom. It is good for me to cling to God, and to place in him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not reveal your mysteries to your adversaries, nor give you a kiss as did Judas, but as the thief I confess you. Remember me, Lord, in your kingdom.
Praise him, all you stars and the light. Praise in heavens of heavens, and water above the heavens, let them praise the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Alleluia.